Hello friends, this video is about synchronizing the threads. We know that the threads in a particular program, multiple threads in a program, are using the same memory which is allocated to the program by the system or the operating system. So therefore, it is quite possible that same set of functions, same instructions or same data, two different threads may try to enter or use or invoke a certain function even if the other thread is also doing the same thing. So there is a possibility of two simultaneous threads entering into a one particular function. So what will happen? As it happens in case of the variable, if you reassign the new value to the variable, the second value is what is persisted with. Similarly, if the function is used by one function and also the second function, the operation done by the first thread will be nullified, and the operation done by the second thread will only be persistent. But obviously you don't want this to happen. So therefore, what you have to do? You have to synchronize the threads. Meaning what? You have to do or provide such a mechanism by which if a particular thread is using or entering or performing a certain function, till the time it exits the function, the other functions should be not allowed to enter into that. So this is a synchronized operation of the function. So in order to synchronize the behavior of these functions, threading class has a lock method. So what should be done? The thread that is first entering into the function or using a certain function has to get hold of the lock. It is in the possession of the lock. So long as a particular thread is in the possession of the lock, the other threads will be blocked. What that particular thread has to do after its execution or after its work with that function is over, that particular thread has to release the lock. So first acquire the lock and then release the lock. If the lock is not released, till the time it is not released, the other functions cannot enter it. For other functions to enter, the first thread should have released the lock. So by such mechanism, the synchronization of activities of more than one threads can be controlled. This is the way in which the synchronization is basically dependent upon the lock, the acquisition of the lock, and the release of the lock. So how these terms are actually put into practice, I'll show you a very interesting, very small but very interesting example to better understand the synchronization of threads.
So this program demonstrates the synchronization of multiple threads. So the synchronization actually is based upon the acquisition and release of a certain lock. So in the threading module, there is a lock class, and this will create a lock object. I'll call it as a thread lock. So in order to ensure that if a particular function is executed by one thread, the others are blocked, in order to ensure that whichever thread is acquiring the lock will be only in possession of the rights to use a particular function, the others will be prohibited so long as the thread doesn't release or relinquish the lock. So this is the basic idea behind the synchronization. So this is the my thread class, which is based upon the base thread class defined in the threading module, right? And then, as I said, the most important thing is the lock object. Here I have defined a list object, list of all the threads that I am going to create. How many threads are being created? Two, thread 1 and thread 2. These are the two objects of the MyThread class. After creating the objects, the constructor will be executed. The initialization part will be done as in the earlier case itself. These two threads are started. Thread 1 dot start and thread 2 dot star. They will respectively call the run function, and the run function, as soon as long as the run function will be executed, the thread will go on. In addition to that, what I am doing is these two threads are added into this list object. So threads dot append, thread 1 and thread 2, these two are added into this. Okay, so I think you got the idea. Two objects are created, two threads are started. Each start will call its respective run. So when the first thread enters the run method, it will print the starting message and it will immediately acquire the lock, so that even if the subsequent thread enters the run function, it will not be able to execute the print time function unless and until the lock is relinquished. After that only the print time function activity related to the second thread will be able to be executed. Okay, so this is the acquire and release mechanism of a lock. After the completion of print time functions of both the threads are allowed to join, and then the program will end by mentioning or giving the exiting main thread message. Okay, so let us see how it behaves. Does it behave as per our expectation or not? There you see the thread 1 is continuously in progress because it is acquiring the lock. After the output of the thread 1 is completed, then only the thread 2, the output of the print me function for the thread 2 is appearing, right? So thread 1 and thread 2, even though they start simultaneously, the thread 1 has acquired the lock. So thread 2 is in wait. Thread 1 completes the function, then only the thread 2 will enter the print me function. Okay, so this is synchronization.